Welcome to the Canoga Park Youth Arts Center's new series, Art Explorer, where each class I'll be teaching you how to draw animals from all over the world. And by showing you how we use basic shapes to create animals, it'll allow you to learn how to draw any animal that you want. So today, our travels are going to take us to the Arctic. Here's the Arctic. It's at the top of the world. The Antarctic is at the bottom of the world, but the Arctic is at the top. And if you were to be there, that's kind of like what you'd see. There's a lot of snow, some mountains, and a lot of ice. I'm going to be showing you how to draw three different animals who live in the Arctic. The first one is our friend the polar bear. And you can see it's a big, chunky animal with big, thick legs. And then our next animal is the Arctic fox, or the snow fox. And he looks a little like a dog. So if you were able to learn how to draw an Arctic fox, you would be able to learn how to draw a dog too. And our last animal is, of course, the penguin. So I'm going to be showing you step-by-step directions on how we can make those three different animals for the Arctic. Let's take a look at what we're going to be doing today. Here is our landscape of the Arctic. Let's take a look at some of the things in my picture. The first thing I want you to notice is the horizon line, the most important line in any landscape. It divides the land from the sky. Now in the Arctic, there are big mountains, so mine, and no two mountains are alike, by the way. So when you make your mountains, remember, mountains are unique as you are. No two are alike. Second thing I want you to notice is that I drew a line under there because this is water and that is an iceberg. I want you to notice how I made this show that my iceberg is floating above the water so my penguin can hitch a ride. This line shows the bank of this lake so that my bear and my snow fox have something to stand on. I put these squiggly lines up here to kind of represent the northern lights or the aurora borealis, but they look best with color. So that's where we're headed today. Let's take a look at these easy steps on how to draw a polar bear to start with. So look, it's a rectangle. That's all it is. I know you guys can draw a rectangle. Then I put my legs on. Now, remember what I said about polar bear legs? They're thick and they're not that long. And they got big feet. So the feet come out like this. And that, well, as soon as you put the feet on, it just starts reading like bear. But of course, we're missing some things to our bear, aren't we? I took a square, not a rectangle, but a square, and I put it at a little angle. That is the neck of our bear. And then I put another rectangle here, but I took a little chunk out of it, because that's the forehead of our bear and that's the nose. I used a couple of circles for the ears. Next thing I did is I rounded off his bottom, gave him a little tiny tail, and then we would add two more legs. That's our bear, really easy. Now let's go down to our penguin. An oval, super easy. An oval with the penguin's little wing there. So far it looks pretty easy to me. Now I'm going to add a head. That's just a circle. And you see it's kind of touching a little bit, little circle there. So now I'm going to take a line and I'm going to join my circle to the body of my penguin. And I'm going to give my penguin his beak. And our final steps are to give our penguin his little tail and to give him his little feet and, of course, an eyeball. Now, our Arctic fox, he's sitting down. So it's always good to know how to draw an animal that's sitting down. We start with this rectangle that's tilted up. And now remember what I said about animals have backward legs. So when our fox is sitting down, it's like this backward two. Do you see how kind of it looks like a backward two? That's how a back legs of an animal are, and that's his paw. Now here, this is the fox's elbow. So we make a little bend right there, and we add a little paw on. So now he's got his back legs and his front legs. Foxes have big, bushy tails. And for our fox's head, foxes have really triangular-shaped heads. So I'm just going to pop a triangle on top of my rectangle. So it's starting to look more and more like a fox. Now, on our final step, I add my eyes. I have lines that come down for a narrow nose. I pop on big ears because foxes have big ears. And then I give him a little bit of fur texture, and I put on an extra leg here and more fur texture. So you can see, and fur texture in his tail too. So you can see that by just using basic shapes, we can create any animal we want, even if they live in the Arctic. All right, let's start our landscape. The most important line is the first line in a landscape. Today it's going to be mountains. The horizon line is the line that divides the sky from the land. And I'm putting mountains in mine, and they're not all alike. Mountains are like you. They're all unique. Now I'm going to draw another line that shows where the mountains stop and the lake begins. There we go. Now the last line that I need is the land that my bear and my fox are sitting on. There we go. So now here is our scene. This is where our animals are going to be. So let's start with our penguin first. And with our penguin, I need to make an iceberg. So I'm going to make an oval. And I'm going to make it like that. Two lines on either side of my oval. And then I go like this. So now this looks like it's a platform that's above the lake. Now for my penguin, remember, we started with an oval. We give him a little wing. Then I put a little circle up here for his head, remember? And the next thing I did was I joined his head to his body. And I gave him his little beak, like that. The last thing we did was add a tail and his little feet. There is our penguin. Ooh, needs an eyeball. There we go. All right, now we're going to draw our polar bear. Remember what I said about that polar bear? It's a big rectangle. That is the body of our polar bear. Now I'm going to give him his big legs with his big claws that come out. There we go. Here's another claw. And we're going to make it go into there a little bit, into our rectangle. Now remember what I said about having that square that's just tilted a little bit? Here's my square, okay? And then I'm going to put my little nose in here, and I said that was like a little rectangle that had a little bite taken out of it. And there's my bear's ears, okay? Can make some adjustment. Here's my second bear leg. There's the back leg. I'm going to smooth off his behind. Give him his little tail. Give him an eyeball. Give him his big black nose. Smile because he's a happy polar bear. He still has a place to live. Now for our last animal, the Arctic fox. Remember what I said about a rectangle that's leaning up like that, right? Now we're going to put in our fox's back legs. And that was like my backward two. Remember that one? Okay, now our fox has his back legs. As long as we're here, we can give him his big bushy tail. There's his big bushy tail. His front legs are a little bent like this. And then there's his front paws. Okay? And then we're going to put his triangle head in. And he's going to be overlapping our iceberg, it appears. There's his big triangle head. We give him his big ears. I'm going to give him a couple of eyes. His little nose. We have these lines that come down. Now I'm going to give him all this fur. Fur, 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 fur. Fur, fur, fur. Fur, 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 fur. There we go. And maybe we can give him a second little leg coming out here. Here's his belly. And there's a second little leg coming out from there. So now we have our three animals. We have our bear, polar bear, we have our Arctic fox, and we have our penguin. So, let's take a look if we wanted to add some color to this. Here is my upgrade. So if you are amongst the kids that's lucky enough to have some watercolor and some crayons or oil pastels, you can take it to the next level. Now, you're going to notice I left a lot of my paper white. Watercolor doesn't have white paint. So anything that's white, you just leave without any paint on it. So I just put a little bit of shadows. Do you see this little bit of blue? Snow in shadow is blue. So I used very light blue to show some shadow on my animals. I made a blue sky, but I left some white showing for the clouds. And you can see I added texture with my oil pastel on my mountains. And I was careful to use different shades of blue. My sky is a darker blue, and this is a lighter blue, so that my water and my sky, there was some way of telling the difference between the two of them. So here is our Arctic picture. I hope you enjoyed going to the Arctic with us today. And remember, if you want to share the artwork you make, please send it to us at the Canoga Park Youth Art Center. We would be glad to post it on Instagram, so show other people what you guys are doing. So thank you for joining us. Join us again for another lesson of Art Explorer.